I just keep having this recurring dream. I'm on MasterChef and I'm cooking rice and beans, and I make decent rice and beans. I even... Please let me talk. Please let me talk. Let me finish. I'm getting the rice and beans ready, and then the MasterChef judge is Hayley, and she keeps telling me she doesn't like it, and I don't know why I keep getting this recurring dream. What's going on?
What's going on, right? What is he doing?
He's on a Kelly house call.
It's the most delicious rice and beans you ever have.
There is not enough time in the world for her to fix it.
Just hang up.
No, it's a loss for us.
It's my time to win a challenge.
We will hang it up for King. 10 hours. We won't even scratch the surface of week one of Brains versus Bronze. Like,
I need to say woohoo more.
And he's not listening to her.
I'm not woohooing
not
enough
working.
In my life.
Hang it up.
Not working.
Is that the problem?
Bad reception there. Sorry.
I am a psychologist.
Welcome back to Australian Survivor Talking Tribal. I'm Survivor expert and podcaster Shannon Guss, here with King George of many Channel 10 shows and Chrissy Zaremba from Blood vs. Water, and the reason Boston Rob follows all of us. Thank you, Chrissy.
Thanks, Chrissy, that's looking a job well done.
Wait, very much.
He followed you as well?
He did.
And he followed you.
And myself, finally.
I know, wow. Yeah, I know you felt special. No, but thank you.
I felt so special.
You're looking beautiful in Titans Blue. I'm in Rebel pink, and George is like the merge tribe.
George is merging. I have a Titan and a Rebel.
I'd say that we did plan this, though. No, we're going to vary. It wasn't just,
fake.
Yeah, it wasn't just like, it happened.
I'm Jaden. I'm all
Jaden
today.
Okay, well, let's travel back to the start of the week with this clip. Do you want to chat?
I'm going swimming with Scott.
I have to be here to pitch my case.
Would you mind just giving us one more minute?
Okay.
Because we're just right in the middle of
I'll come back.
Something. Yeah, thank you.
I'll
sorry.
Eileen couldn't get anywhere. Getting rebuffed like that. What did we think of Eileen in this episode? This whole week, I felt, was such an interesting week for Eileen. Obviously, starts with her playing the double agent, trying to get in such a tricky spot. She's going to win some challenges. She's going to get through on some good gameplay around some big twists. What do we think of Eileen this week?
You go. Because mine is... simple. I don't think you can't be a double agent. Simple as that. That's just my theory. And I don't think it's working for her. And that face there is exactly what I wanted to be on the screen because she's not buying it. That's just my opinion.
It's very interesting that you framed it that way, Chrissy. So I think in terms of being a double agent...
Yeah, Chrissy, you can't be a double agent. Cut to George all the time. He was a double agent.
When you have that double agent kind of agenda... you can either do it when you're in control of the situation or when you're basically... on the bottom and doing anything to scrap and survive.
I'm happy if you're up top. But if you're where our girl is at the moment...
And I think we saw it at the last tribal council before Garrick went home. Yeah. And we saw Eileen immediately go to Kirby, it wasn't me, it wasn't me. And then she was explaining herself.
But I didn't vote for you.
In that clip, I think there's a very clear distinction to make. So Eileen did what she did, which I understand. It's not my particular style in terms of trying to get from second bottom... to third bottom. I think it's immaterial. You stick with your people to the death.
Yeah.
But what you saw was Kirby said, no, I'm going to go swim with Scott. And Charles said something very different. He said, can you give me a minute? I mean, how would you feel, Chrissy, if someone's like having a strat chat? No, just give us 3 minutes. We're having the very important one that you can't
listen. No, I'm swimming,
Yeah, they didn't even really pretend to let her in. I think it's very hard for Eileen. Like, this is a very difficult spot and I don't credit, you know, what she was doing, but I don't know that she could do much more other than try throw Raymond under the bus, which just makes her look even flakier and probably won't work. But I do think, I agree, like, saying to Kirby, oh, I didn't vote for you, and Kirby would know that. So this part I thought was just, like, such an unfortunate spot of the week for Eileen, but I felt like she built it back in a way that was really impressive, winning both challenges, and I'm sure we'll talk about the episode 11 challenge. And what I really liked that she did, when the twist happens and they have a 2-to-1 vote, I was like, please split the vote. You know, you wouldn't think necessarily that that's a difficult thing to think about, that you can split on a 2-1, but in the moment with a last minute twist, you never know. People don't think of the split, but I knew Eileen would. She is the split queen. I feel like she should change her name from Eileen to I Split. Mm. Like, she's always splitting, so...
She's doing
that's her domain.
Things.
Yeah.
I mean, there's one thing that Eileen can control, and it's how she regulates her time in the game. So Eileen made a choice to spend time, which is the most valuable currency in the game of Survivor, pitching herself to... give some kind of bottom feeding information. That's a choice. What Eileen could have also done with her time is trying to win back people back into her camp, into Ferris's camp. That's not what she did. I think we saw by the end of the episode something changed with Eileen where she went and said, no, I'm going to stick with Ferris and this is the best thing for my game. And yeah. I applaud her doing that and showing some conviction.
She's going to choose this decision and stick by it.
100%. Well, maybe. Such a tough episode for that minority. What do we think about Raymond in all of this?
Raymond's come from nowhere. Like, I recall him walking through the track and sort of saying to Ferris, all right, well, if you find one, if you get an idol, you should play it, but don't tell me. Like, he's sort of a bit standoffish, but you think he's extremely loyal.
I think
loyal.
He was very loyal. Like, Eileen is the one playing double agent, letting her hair down. I feel like, firstly, Eileen is such a super fan. She just wants to do, like, a hair down, hair up kind of thing, just to be, you know, have that fun code, which kind of appeals to, like, super fans like Eileen and Charles maybe. But for Raymond, I felt like they were trying to appeal to him, and he was like, I feel like he's so loyal to Ferris. You'll only trust him now.
Mm. Who would you choose out of your alliance if you had to vote out?
Out of Eileen and Ferris.
No, you have to write one of the names down, right?
So I think he's quite key to Ferris going forward. But I mean, I think for Ferris as well, this is such a tough spot. It was interesting to me. He goes to Winner and he's like, you know, Kirby's gonna have a lot of numbers. That's very dangerous. And he goes to Kirby. He's like, where are the numbers? Winner and BG, it's interesting as well because Kirby is so powerful. Like, she is amassing so much power, and I think people should be really scared of her, but I don't think that the Titans at that point can flip-flop. So I think they've made their bed, they're going to lie in it, and I just think it's just a really, really tricky situation.
You just said then how Kirby's powerful and stuff. She still only really has... She has this ridiculous sort of hold over all of them, but she's really ridiculously loyal to Scott, right?
Yeah.
Mm. Everyone
and
else
she's going to have Rihanna.
Yeah.
Do you know what, Chrissy? I think on Kirby's numbers position, I think Ferris is absolutely spot on. Kirby moving forward has no one outside of Rhee and Scott. But do you know why Kirby doesn't care? Because that's a problem for another day. And when your people management skills are just as strong and 10 out of 10 as Kirby's are, she will fix the problem when you need to fix it.
I don't think it's a problem.
It is a problem, but she's got the capacity and the capability
to fix it. Or even when it comes, when the problem arises.
I think she has Winner and Valeria going forward. I think that Mark could be in that. I think Jaden's an option. I think that she has the skills to kind of build that group. And I think that people might not be worried enough about her.
Yep.
Although Kelly did say, go, and like left this departing message. So maybe Ferris will kind of team up with the middle-aged mafia there to kind of really get Kirby. But I don't know. I just see her as really, really powerful. But something to kind of upend that power. We're going to get to this tribal council. And before it gets all really twisty, there's going to be some heated exchanges. I honestly feel this whole season of tribal councils has been so entertaining. People say what they mean.
This tribal council, this was a clear expose on what not to do from Charles. Now, Charles has had a two-day alliance with Kirby, and it was joined by Valeria, not by Charles. But for Charles to start attacking Aileen, who is...
That was weird.
Not necessarily the leader of the warring faction, but someone that you might be able to make a plan with. She's a super fan as well, like Charles is. Mm. She's someone that's strategic. She's someone that is willing to do stuff. She's been begging people to work with them. Why would you start attacking Eileen? And why would you start going to Ferris? You know, you're antagonizing him. You didn't play the idol for Garrick. It's like, what have you done, bro?
Okay, well...
You've sat there like a mouse, done
really
absolutely nothing, and then talked your way out of the game, basically.
I think we might be seeing some of George's bias come across because it wasn't just Charles who had some words. Actually, we had what my autocue is calling vicious vow. Let's take a look at this clip.
Because you have a very poor leadership skills. When you form an alliance, every single person should have a voice. And that's what you did throughout the whole situation.
No,
not yet, sorry, I haven't finished.
Okay, I'll let you finish, please. Go for gold.
And what I witnessed yesterday with Eileen, she was right in front of us saying, hey, these three are not going with us. Why are you trusting them? And she was actually begging for you to use the idol for Garrick. And you shut her down like a dog.
Yeah, so I think, you know, obviously Valeria had her own comments. You know what I would have said if I was Ferris?
Mm.
You know why I didn't play my idol? Because I really trusted you. You blindsided me. Are you joking? I thought this was hypocritical.
Mm.
Why are they so mad at this minority? Look, they came to them genuinely. They wanted to work with them. Ferris's group wanted to work with them. And they didn't choose that group, which is fine. But obviously they're desperate and upset. Like, why are you blaming them? They're the victims in this. So I thought that this was unnecessarily harsh from that whole alliance to kind of come back at this. You've had the win. You got put in a good spot. You used it well. Ferris's group have lost on that. They have to wear that. But, like, why are you mad at them? Like, what did they do?
My fear for Val, because I've got a big crush on Val.
Who don't you have a crush on? Starting to lose all meaning.
I'm questioning a few things, trust me. This is a very sexy women's car. sorry. No, but with Val, I'm not saying she's getting too big for her boots, but this power and this assertiveness and her confidence, I just don't want it to come across too, because she's kind of out there and saying whatever she wants to say at the moment.
I think people can't escape their life context. And I think when you're dealing with Val, you're dealing with someone that has had kind of like firm life views and firm ways on things happen. And I think if you understand how Val thinks, and this is my understanding of her, she has to make her own decision, and that's the way that you kind of deal with her. And it reminds me of how Haley used to deal with Wei and how I used to deal with Wei in the Outback. You had to let Wei make her own decision, and then reason or logic or whatever kind of lever would come to the fore. With Val, has Ferris done anything particularly bad to her? Not that I've seen.
No.
But I mean, if she's got that self kind of self-perception that, you know, he's her master, as she said at that tribal council.
And talk like a dog.
That's
like
an issue
her.
For Ferris. But unfortunately for Val, I kind of agree with you there, Chrissy. It's how the other players start perceiving Val.
Yeah.
Where if a little bit of power gets to your head, then you start getting snarky. I think the difference between Val and Charles there was simple.
You like Val, you're like
Val enabled Kirby last week.
Not me.
And it comes down to the fact that Survivor's a 24/7 game. And Kirby has formed a connection with Val that is based on people management, upbringing, life experience, whatever it is, they have that connection. And
Ferris and
Eileen make a tactical choice that connection may be more valuable to them.
Yeah.
Off with Charles.
Bye, Charlie.
Is it? Charles. No, it's Charles. Remember we introduced you to Charles recently
him and Raymond. Raymond's dropping, what's Eileen doing with her life after this?
Eileen probably doesn't have much of a future once this is finished.
It's like these guys say three things and then they get broken down. Shut up already. Savage.
Well, the Titans are about to learn why you maybe aren't so harsh at Tribal Council, even when you have a 6-3 majority, because tonight's going to be a little bit different. There's going to be a twist. You guys have had your fair share of twists. Chrissy, you had clown car full of people come back into the game.
Back and forth. Mm. Vote out two, bring back seven.
Bring back seven.
Yeah. I remember,
we're starting the game again.
No, where did they go?
They went to purgatory.
Perjury, that's where they went.
No, it's purgatory. No, what's the real
purgatory? Purgatory.
No, it's not perjury.
That's what you said.
Oh, yeah, I know. I said that.
It's called purgatory. Yeah.
Apparently there's this prejudice. What is it?
Purgatory.
It's not judiciary.
Purgatory.
Prodigy.
Purgatory.
Give me the first three.
Purgatory.
Perjury. No.
Purgatory.
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 What does it mean?
I don't need to be name checked on my words.
I really just questioned her. So I am aware of where they went.
Yeah,
they kept coming back in. Who was it?
They came in the pajama.
What's the point? I'll go over.
What's going on there? We're coming back. 10 more people. Starting again the whole show. Not Pajero, purgatory.
Bring another four-wheel drive. We need more. Bring Shay back a sixth time. She might do something.
Yeah, they brought back everyone except Croc.
See, that's too soon.
It has been 4 years. It feels like four. Four in now much time.
I'm putting it on.
Why?
Are we putting on our idol?
No. Just in loving memory.
Anyway, we're still talking about this episode of Don't Take Down the Set. We asked one week for you guys not to ruin the set.
We've actually have a special.
No, I didn't.
I expected this. Just give it. Give it to me.
All right.
All right, it's mine.
Anyway, I'm trying to I'm trying to corral my own clown card here.
I'm wearing this bad boy. I never got to wear it.
George, you had twists.
Yeah, a I had twist. Yeah. My number two ally was voted off, and then Haley threw me over and voted me and threw me under the bus. But
the bus of the people coming back from purgatory was that the same bus?
Let's run through the numbers in this twist.
I'm just going to get a quick picture in this.
We're going through the twist, Chrissy.
Look at this. I never got to wear it.
Guys, friends, I feel like I'm going to get blamed for this.
Go ahead, Chrissy. There was a twist. The numbers
in the twist. This is how it works, Shannon. There was a 1 in 12 chance, about 8%, of 2 out of 3 people from the Ferris camp, which is Ferris, Eileen and Raymond, in having a vote at that tribal council, because only 3 players could get a vote.
Yep.
So the probability of both Eileen and Ferris winning that challenge is quite low. Is it a bit unlucky in terms of the fact from, say, Kirby or Charles or Val's perspective that they become completely powerless? Yes, it is.
Very unlucky.
It was completely improbable. But props to Eileen and to Ferris and to Kirby for delivering under pressure. I've done one of those night challenges. And sometimes when you have to react under pressure, the cream rises to the top. Eileen smashed that challenge in about 15 seconds.
Very determined.
And we had a photo
finish. It's like she knew. It's like her and Ferris knew before they even started, we got this in the bag. I felt like that.
The photo finish between Ferris, Winner, Charles, it was incredible to watch.
Yeah,
and it was a good challenge.
And then it just completely changed the game.
And Winner is so interesting to me here because he's like, I want the votes on me. Mm. How do you do that? It's so tricky.
He nearly nailed it.
It was so obvious.
It was so bad. I was laughing, literally, I will never work with you.
Yeah, it's just like he's gone.
I hate you and your family.
Maybe I just like him.
He's gone from being a mouse to just be going, hi, everyone.
No, it was bad.
For the first time, I'm going to make strategic advice. Vote for me. You might as well hold up a big sign that says, I don't have an idol.
Well, you might as well have a sign that says, well, usually don't vote for Winner. In a world where they can't split, you put the idol on and then you play it and then you get implicit immunity. You play it for Val or for Charles. But because they could split, he had to play it on himself, which they're like, Ferris, you don't need to play the idol on yourself. Cut to Winner. Playing it on himself, which makes sense because, of course, you want that protection. He has to play it on himself. I understand what he was trying to do. I just think it's so hard. Like, in that moment at tribal council, what you have to do is you have to make people think you're acting like you want to work with them, but you're lying. But it's so hard.
You could do the opposite. You can actually make a deal with them and promise to work with them.
Like, we
think outside the square. Think outside the square. What's stopping Charles walking up like this? And go,
Georgie.
Oh no, my audio pack's gone. So that would have been a disaster if that ever happened on Survivor.
You can walk
up at a tribal council and you can go, let's cut a deal in real time. I am so sorry, and we will be in the numbers moving forward.
Well, I thought it was interesting that Kirby was like, tell me where to vote.
Please do, I beg you to go back.
So, but Kirby was like, tell me where to go. And I kind of felt like she was kind of ushering it off scot.
Credit where credit's due, though. How good did Eileen and Ferris split those votes, though?
I loved it. No, she's a split queen.
Yeah, but it was perfection. And in my mind, I'm screaming, split it, please.
And they did. I agree. Thank God they thought about it on the spot. And it is really tricky, I'm sure, to do it in that situation. Okay, let's take a break. When we're back, who are the rebels meant to be voting for? We're all so confused, especially Chrissy. She doesn't know what's going on.
I'm so confused.
we're overcomplicating things, people.
Welcome back to Australian Survivor Talking Tribal. Eileen smashed the immunity challenge in episode 11 of Titans vs. Rebels. Were either of you singing Come On Eileen? Were we rooting for her?
I was. I feel like she
knew.
We
don't have the rights to that, Chrissy.
Huh?
The song.
We don't have to pay for that.
Anyway, go
on. Put it on the tab. No, I felt like she just had no choice. She was winning that no matter what. She was holding it like a boss. Kitty was a challenger.
Mm.
Kitty had that in the bag. Well, I've got the giggles about something. Wait. Oh, they can cut this. But maybe you thought you'd won a challenge. Shannon, wait. This story really makes me laugh because I felt like Kitty was really in that. But Eileen just knew she was
going to
win.
When George thought he wanted a challenge.
Yeah, remember that one? I actually watched this episode.
I was watching the drowning challenge I was in at Chrissy's house, and I was just retelling my experience. Like, I felt like I was underwater for, like, hours. And when I came out, there was so much water in my ear. So I came out thinking at least I'm first or second, and then the level of disappointment when I was the first one out was huge, but
I came out thinking I'd won. He was telling us that he looked around and to his despair, everyone was still in it. And he's like, I'm the first out. I thought I'd been there for 6 hours.
Yeah.
Whereas our kitty girl, she was a bit shaky at the end, but wow, she's a force to be reckoned with. But
yeah.
Eileen, sorry.
Super impressed with Eileen.
Eileen really impressed me though. Like, that challenge looked extremely hard, particularly when it got to the top of it. Did I have Eileen being a challenge beast on my bingo card? No, not at the start of the season. Do I welcome this development? Yes. And I'll reiterate what I said last week. Good things happen when you listen to Eileen, like winning the challenge.
Well, okay. This was a lot of fun challenge moments. I'm like, stop making me care about the challenges. But like, Eileen really pushing it as a super fan. No, we don't. We're not. We're talking tribal. We're not talking challenges.
I'm starting a different show.
Chrissy's challenge. Chats with Chrissy.
Challenge chats with Chrissy. Well, that's not...
You watch my ratings,
well,
baby.
Actually,
Boston Rob visitor.
I don't know, because we're in Boston. We're Jaden with the three-point show. That was also impressive.
He was nailing
that
those threes.
That was crazy. It was literally in like one film shot.
Way ahead?
Oh, so
that
far ahead. Genuinely,
ahead.
It was shocking.
Jaden was just boom, boom, boom.
I know.
You can imagine me. I was shooting with him.
He's on fire! Let's go!
Don't distract me from about the challenges.
Okay, guys, sorry.
But it was cool. But then they lost the challenge because Eileen was a boss. And then they go back to Rebels Beach and this happens.
Where are you?
I'm voting for Mark. That's what the girls have said.
Yep, okay.
If that's true or not, I don't know.
Okay. Yeah, well, every conversation Mark has been.
Oh, okay,
so,
yep.
I'm just trying to figure out what's, like, what's the fake conversation.
In terms of, so, myself, Kitty, and you.
Oh, that just changed.
No, you two remind me then. I can't remember. I know who I'm voting for, but I can't remember who.
I was meant to be on the split. I was meant to be on the split. Because you told Jaden to vote for Alice.
Yeah. Did I?
Yeah, so is just Jaden confused or more people confused?
I was confused. They're all confused. And Mark, I reckon that's the absolute beginning of when Caroline cooked it a little bit and he was suspicious. And I reckon I'm going to say, and I'm going to stand by it, I don't know what your two thoughts are on it, that was the greatest decision for her to come out of this.
To bring it back onto what should have been Alex?
100%. Mm.
I mean, obviously this vote's not going to happen, but I think...
That's a mess.
I don't think they could make this happen for one reason. And that person is Chrissy's segment, Where's Eden? Eden and Mark continue to be,
yes,
you know, that
Shannon.
Connection. But the first time that Caroline and Eden talk alone is at the very, very end of this whole scramble.
Yeah.
And she says to him, I don't know. And that's when the plan starts getting pulled back. I think it's delicate to get Eden to vote out Mark. And I just don't think she had the time to finesse that plan through.
Shannon, I think in the grand scheme of things, it wasn't necessarily bad for Caroline what happened.
In terms of to take it back to Alex?
My question isn't necessarily... Gross. Where's Eden? It's where's Mark? You're standing there in sweet mafia boss Caroline, because I've got to keep adding those adjectives to her name now. But sweet mafia boss Caroline has just clearly stuffed up. She knows what the vote is. You're standing there. You've had this fake makeup mea culpa with each other. You know it's not real, both of you. And the vote's getting confusing.
Yeah.
She's voting for you, buddy. Like, get with the program.
Yeah.
Like, Mark has to smell...
No, he smelled it.
Did he, though?
I don't think he did. In confessional, he keeps telling us.
Proof in the pudding. What does Mark do at the tribal council? He listens to sweet Caroline. Correct. Sweet mafia boss Caroline. So when sweet mafia boss Caroline changes the vote to Alex at tribal council, it is indisputable in my mind who's in control of that tribe. There she is right there.
Yes, I don't think that Mark knows. I think that he's, like, really grasping at straws because all he has, I don't think so. He tells us in confessional often, he's like, I guess we're back together. And I'm like, I don't know how
I'm
you
still
think
not buying that.
That.
I'm still not buying it.
Why, he's not going to lie to us in confessional. No, it's like the one time where we know, it. And he says it with his lips, like that, he literally did say it.
No, I think he believes it. He should know. Like when he says it, even when he goes, I think the mafia, he's not even believing his own words because he's with the others. But for this, I saw his face. I feel like Caroline went, oh my God. I actually don't know what I'm doing
she
here.
She did a stuff. She stuffed up.
She did the. And then he was. Yeah. And then I feel like he was like thinking about Eden. That was. I was sweaty. I had BO from this.
Well, we're all here with you. Well,
it's good. Go. No, smell. Smell now. It's beautiful.
So
now.
I'm so glad to be here on this hosting couch away from you for so many different reasons.
Hate me all over.
Focus. Well, no, I mean, I think that Mark just. He doesn't have another option right now than to just throw all of it in with the middle-aged mafia, which he should have done.
Except Alex. Everyone had an option at this tribal council.
Why? So,
well, and sweet mafia boss Caroline whipped him into shape.
No, I think that what they did with the twist was it was just as painless as possible to get through the twist and just not upsetting people when everyone's going to stay in the game. Look, and I thought that was fine.
I'm cheering on Caroline.
I can tell.
I'm very proud that Caroline has asserted her bossness over this tribe. It was good for Caroline.
Well,
bad for Mark.
Well, it's Mark's in a tricky
bad
spot.
For Mark moments, though.
Yeah, like, it's not been a good couple. It hasn't
been a great couple.
You think I was so? On the... Why don't you think so?
Yeah, well, this will hurt. This will... No, I just feel like he came out guns blazing. He was fire. And I'm like, oh, my God, the bald guy's going to win.
Bald guy's
going to
win.
He can swim, he can talk.
And this is why we pay you to be here.
Where's Eden?
Where's Eden? Every week you ask where Eden is, he's right there.
I've got a crush on it.
He's there. He's listening to his boss. Caroline.
Well,
move on.
What about someone that George loves in Jaden? I thought Jaden was going to accidentally vote Mark, and I was going to get Mark go to the kind of play that George loves.
No, this is a kids show. Kids watch this, don't they?
I don't know. Does anyone watch
like
this?
Like a hard out drug
Can
dealer.
Can I tell you this? If I hear Eshe one more goddamn time, I am throwing my remote at the TV.
Eshe.
Jaden's funny. Don't skip over. He said some really funny things.
People find Jaden funny.
We'll circle back to this because in 12, I think him and...
Was it Yeah,
it was
the
in
girl?
The challenge. It was in the challenge. It was... He's. I think that Jaden is funny, but he's a difficult ally.
Yes, agree. Like, where is he? He's on holiday. What's he doing? Yeah.
Name the joke.
Oh, when he... No, what? No, he is funny. Things, he babe. Does have a... He's got more TikTok followers than you do. People must find him pretty entertaining.
I don't know what a TikTok is.
Well, that's on you.
We had this discussion last week.
Well, I think Jaden is a difficult ally to have if he's going to get confused. It's going okay. It kind of reminds me of... He's a bit like Chrissy, it's true. He's like a Chrissy.
No, but he does sort of go...
Really funny.
Funny, good looking.
Basketball champion.
Basketball champion.
A little confused.
Good skin.
I think
doesn't
Jaden,
know what's going on.
Doesn't know what's happening.
I'm joking.
Did he get on? Did he take a family or loved one on?
No, he's on TikTok.
Oh, okay.
And I'm sure he applied. He's a big fan of the show. Anyway.
I love
you. You're lying to all
I'm
of our joking, faces
am,
right
I am,
now.
I am, I am. Okay. It's time for World of Survivor. Okay, on World of Survivor, I want to talk about the vote economy. When you lose or give up votes and the whole structure of a vote
Boo!
Changes, which
Boo!
I know I'm not a fan of. Are you booing me or vote economy?
Stealing votes away.
I also am not a fan of people losing votes. I'm so sorry. I know we're talking about Survivor here on this Network 10 property, but you had it, as we're saying, when you lost your number two ally, Baden. Questions on where he is in terms of George's friends list, but Baden went home, and this
Mummy?
Is something... We see...
Don't make me judge my friends. It's all...
This is something we see a lot on US Survivor, where they actually have, like, in the new era, a shot in the dark. You can give up your vote at any time for a 1 in 6 shot at safety. You have one chance of that per game. And it's something that really changes the nature of the game when you're not going to have, obviously, all of the votes. And something like what we see with 3 votes of 9 and Charles is going to go home. But Chrissy... Do you know?
Mm.
This is my
like
new. This
before.
Is what.
What doesn't Chrissy know?
Mm-hmm. Well, again, we don't have all day.
Yeah.
But
you're
no,
so
I know. No, I know. I know. Do you know that someone once went home with 0 votes? Look at her face.
Chrissy,
should be.
I'm just
know
trying
this.
To think how.
This isn't actually vote economy, but I thought that I wanted an excuse to tell you this. No, I'll tell her which world of survival with Shannon.
Oh.
What? What
it's not an Australian person.
No, but it is the best person alive. Sari Fields. Remember last week I told you the Black Widow Brigade?
Yeah, I liked it.
Legend of the show, different season that she was on. Final six, all five people.
Talk slower.
Had advantages and idols, all other people.
Love
she went home with zero votes. They all played an idol or an advantage.
What are the chances?
And I was at, remember, I was at a viewing party and I lost it.
Yeah, that's heavy.
And I never came back.
What's her name?
Sari Fields. You should look her up. She's a queen. But also, they call it advantage getting. That's what the fans call it.
Yeah, right.
It was a nightmare.
So, that was for a revote.
What?
The Sari vote.
A Sari vote.
A revote in the Sari.
Well, how could you revote? They were all immune.
I've missed a name again. Say it once more.
Sari Fields.
Fields is the surname. Right. That's unfair.
I know.
Spewing.
Yeah. Well, I mean, look, Charles went home with two votes of nine, three people voting. I feel bad for Charles. I feel bad when the vote economy, especially when there's not agency in it, you know, stuff like winning a challenge for that, it's a very unfortunate spot. So I've got to feel a little bit bad for Charles. I guess we're going to get to that when we cruelly put down his little tiny Who board.
Poor Charles.
All right, it is time to take a break. Stay with us for the glory and death of Kelly. Welcome back. Some will rejoice, others will be sad to see her go. Let's take a look at the start of Kelly's downfall.
I just think we get rid of Raymond first.
I don't want to do that. He's your weakest player. Why would you want to target a weakest player?
He's an extra vote to them.
He's an extra vote.
So you just want to get rid of a pawn on the chessboard. You can't dictate to me how I vote when it comes to Raymond. No one will ever dictate that to me. You think you will try, but you will not.
He's not even in our alliance.
It doesn't matter. It's about the person he's been to me through this whole game.
I think you need to remove your emotion and see it from a game perspective, because I think you're speaking too emotionally when it comes to him.
I think it's you need to take time to think how this game works for a moment, and then do a few forward thinking of what things can take you through. So we're not playing one big family. We're playing a game.
Are you assuming I don't think, Val?
That is so tense.
Wait. Anyway.
What happened there?
That was great. What do we think?
I think
she's so defensive.
Yeah, but do you know what? I don't think she's wrong. I don't think she's wrong. You're allowed to defend your people. I think what was missing in that entire very tense scene was Kirby, who has been flawless in terms of people management up until that point. Because the response when Kelly goes, "I don't want it to be Ray," should be, "Who would you rather it be, Kelly? Who would you rather it be?"
Yeah, yeah.
And then Kelly probably never has a problem.
But then Kelly will probably have a really bad idea. The thing is, Raymond is a good vote in a very tricky situation where that they can't split. That alliance has one going on two idols. This is even before they're going to have the feast or search, where the other three non-Raymond people from that alliance are going to go search for the idol. So Raymond is a fairly good bet. But unfortunately, Kelly is holding this alliance hostage and they're not acting like it. They're acting like she's dispensable, but she's not dispensable to them. So that's why I feel like they actually can't dictate to Kelly. They're in a tough position, but I've been pretty positive on how Kirby has been able to utilize someone like Kelly. It is playing with fire. You know, maybe with someone like Stevie, to have a chaotic player like that. Someone like Boston Rob did this the best it's ever been done with Philip, and now Chrissy knows that.
Yeah, and Kirby's worked it out. She's let her be here for as long as she can. Now she's going to be too much danger for this.
I disagree. Not too much danger because this is what it is. When they get rid of Kelly, had they gone back to a tribal council, it would have been 4-4. Ferris's group has two idols. They're almost definitely hitting on the idol, and if they're not and they go to rocks, they're pretty much protected other than one person on rocks. Kirby has lost all the power in this. Now, Kelly is a liability. I'm not saying she's not, but I think Kirby has to work harder to be like, whatever you want, keep her close until she's a number you can expend, and that is not now. So I'm pretty harsh on how Kirby got rid of Kelly here.
It's hard to... I never, ever thought of my allies as expendable, because that was the red line, and the only person I ever did it to was Stevie, but that was a very...
That wasn't fair. You were pushed into...
It was because I had a multi-alliance strategy going, and it was a red line for Shawnee and Liz.
Yeah.
So I had to make a judgment call which alliance was more important to me, the one with Stevie and Jerry or the one with Shawnee and Liz. And I told myself I can cut Stevie, as sad as it was, keep Jerry and Shawnee and Liz and move into merge. In Kirby's mind, she's made a judgment call that it takes too much time and energy to micromanage Kelly.
Yeah, that's
I can accept that.
Yeah, I'm with that.
I can accept that.
Shan, she literally...
I get it. I'm not saying she's not a liability.
You guys can do your rock talk because you lost me a bit there with that and your split stuff, but this is plain simple to me. Kelly has just come out. She was, no, you can't talk to me like that. Don't you dare expect me to go against my darling Raymond. Well, who's in your alliance?
Really, when I look at it, Kirby got a little bit lucky that Ferris didn't pick up Kelly. Okay?
Oh, we'll
because
talk about that.
Kirby didn't really think of the consequences of Kelly going rogue.
That's what I'm saying.
Okay? So what could have happened, and what I thought probability-wise was more likely, is Ferris walks up to Kelly and goes,
come with us.
I protect Raymond, you protect Raymond. Look at this. Raymond brings us together.
We have something in common. We love Raymond.
We're the triangle.
Everybody loves Raymond.
We love Raymond.
Yeah.
You come and work with me. Instead, what happened, to give Kirby credit, and this is where
Kirby
shines, Kirby goes up to Ferris and says, this is my problem. You have a problem with this person since the start. We don't like Kelly. So unfortunately, we don't like Kelly was stronger in terms of a strategy than we all love Raymond.
Hey, let's talk about what I thought was a really fun twist in this episode. They get to choose to search for an idol.
Yeah.
They all to feast.
All going
what would
feast.
You guys do? What would you do in
no
this
way,
situation?
I'm feasting. Forget it. I'm going in there to talk to everyone.
You're feasting now, even though we just had lunch. You're like, if I eat today,
will we break? No, I'm at the feast. I'm so sure that I don't care about the idol. Like,
George too.
If the idol's going to be bad,
can you imagine?
What I really liked about it, what I really liked about it is they all had to make the decision simultaneously.
Yeah, they couldn't talk about it.
Rather than going or talking about it or being put in a situation where you have to go one by one, it's turn over the rock that you decide. So I think if I was going to transport in there, the real determinative factor is how we're having a feast, you've got to assume merge is soon. How am I putting that piece of the puzzle together? If I have the slightest bit of uncertainty, I'm going back to the beach and getting the idol. What I do like about that feast component is it does give you the chance to speak. So I utilised that very, very well in Heroes v Villains because that's when I had absolutely zero certainty that Flick was with myself, Liz and Shawnee at that merge feast. Because Flick was just doing basically what Kelly was doing at that feast, constantly talking to the other side. And then you tell yourself, why is this happening? I think Kirby used that feast really well.
Mm-hmm.
I feel Kel wasn't subtle enough, though.
No.
Yeah, did you like what she was doing at the feast?
No, Shannon.
He's like a pro footy player.
Ferris is
relegation
I was watching her like, shove the chicken in your mouth. Actually, I think it didn't Kirby
I want
say
chicken.
Something like, put some food in your mouth, woman, and shut up.
Can you just put food in your mouth?
No, please.
All the food you possibly can, woman.
Look, but this is what, it is important for Kirby to be there for the diplomacy, to see what's going on, to make those connections, to be in control. You know who I'm harsh on?
Hear what's happening.
Scott is Kirby's right hand, and I know it's his game, and he doesn't necessarily see himself as a deputy.
Tell me.
I think
wasn't expecting
Scott,
this.
Scott needs to go back to look for an idol. Scott, we pay you to be here.
Oh, no,
no, I don't.
But I can't be sitting here going, oh, I love. Scott, let me just get a visual. Hang on. No, I'm actually not joking.
I can't breathe.
Scott. Oh, looks like Val. Yep.
Looks like Val.
One blondie.
Oh, that looks like Val. Well, that's very kind to Scott.
I just
I think.
Was looking.
Oh
for...
my God.
Okay. I'm gonna go back to
him and Kirby are tight. Oh, yeah, good. Okay.
He's Kirby's right hand.
Yep. Uh-huh.
Kirby needs to be like a queen at the feast. Is anyone listening to me?
You know,
I am in the hosting chair.
He's joking, Shan.
I don't care.
Sorry, George. See, that shows she does not care.
Yeah. So okay. Scott is the number two.
Yeah.
Scott needs to let Kirby look around, yeah. Mm-hmm. Make connections.
Yeah.
Scott needs to go back,
yeah,
and be
idol.
An eye on, yeah. Finding the idol, seeing someone find the idol. Uh-huh. That is your position as a deputy, but because they ensured
Bravo,
by
Shannon.
All of them doing
things. Let's clap.
Bravo,
okay.
No, because I agree with you, but for that
no,
I agree.
But then you do
but
all
do you know? Do you know? Do you know who wasn't thinking that?
Oh, God.
Scott.
Well, clearly, but that's, I'm
because
just saying.
Because Scott does as he's told.
So interesting to see Valeria getting back together with Kitty and Caroline. And to be fair, they did tell her the truth. And she's like, I don't believe you. There's nothing I think
she's
they could have
happy.
Said to appease. Mm. Chrissy's still upset about Viola. How do you think Valeria feels?
I'm livid about it.
Yeah, exactly. So
poor Val.
Try and think some variation of that is how she feels. She's so mad. Valeria's so mad.
Yeah.
She was going to go for them. It's super critical. It's annoying. I get that it's emotional. I don't blame her for
it. It's personal. She just, when it happens, you feel it and you go, oh, gosh. Okay. Like, you know you're doing it as
well. What's the rule, Chrissy?
Oh.
What's the rule? You get emotional.
And you are predictable.
You get predictable.
Oh,
and it's a golden rule of survival.
Did you come up with that? He told me that.
Of course I did. It's in my book. But it's a golden rule. It's a golden rule of survivor.
Yeah.
It's a benefit and a curse for Valeria. So Valeria's going to be predictable. We know who Valeria doesn't like moving forward. She doesn't seem to like Ferris.
Yep.
She calls him master. She's definitely angry about Caroline, mafia boss Caroline.
She don't believe Kitty.
There's a revenge mission there, and she doesn't believe Kitty.
Where are her friends?
Yeah. Where are her friends? Yeah. But she's got enemies, and that means you can start building a plan together. I'd be weary of Val moving forward at the merge. But I'd be scared if I was Caroline, Kitty and Ferris.
Yes, I've seen Russian Revenge before. I think I've seen this film before. It wasn't a great ending for George, but yeah, let's see where that goes. In terms of Chrissy's challenge chat.
Yeah.
That
you
final
get Jaden
challenge,
Jaden and Mark.
Jaden and Mark. Mark in the water.
This
is he a
guy,
fish man? Is he more fish than man?
It's wild because he does not look like a swimmer.
Like, we barely have functional council pools in Western Sydney, and this guy grows up in Townsville and goes bang.
He's got no hair, he's like a seal.
I love how Jaden was just holding, and Raymond was like, this reminds me of high
school. I can't remember how these were all picked.
Jaden has both the Titans tied up. This is going to be an easy win. Wow.
Well, sadly, it does lead to the biggest death of the season in Kelly.
Uh-huh.
Let's talk about it in Glory or Death.
Glory or Death. Let's go.
Glory or Death.
Glory!
Should we chat about Kelly? Because I think it was a glorious death. I feel like Kelly was a very complex character. I feel like she was a bit misunderstood. Yes, she's very kooky and whatnot. Was she the best strategist? No. But the fact that she went out on a real kind of like moral stand defending Raymond, who she had a bond with since the very first days
she
on Rebel
loved
Beach.
Raymond. She really did.
She
love
did.
Raymond.
And for that reason, I cool. think she goes cool. out as a hero and it's a glorious death. What do you think on that?
No. She played herself out of the game. She played herself out of the game. She had a one-way ticket to getting zero votes at the final tribal council, and she didn't want to take that, which maybe is better, honestly. Like, I don't know that that would have been a great way for her to go, like, several more weeks when she's not even going to get more money, but she played herself out of the game, and Raymond has shown to be loyal, like, to Ferris. He's not loyal to Kelly.
No,
that was the wrong stand to take.
But he did look for an idol for him.
Did he?
He was
I saw
not
him
looking.
Very
second
chill.
Time.
He wasn't
after
looking.
Very, ooh,
very
my
chill.
Knee hurt.
She's
going to
watch. She's going to watch that back and go.
You know what they call what Raymond was doing? Weaponized incompetence with the looking for the idol because he wasn't.
Well, we've got to send Kelly.
Yeah, no, we're going to send her. But Kel was great TV.
She was great.
Whether you were cringing,
she was so much fun.
Laughing, there was some sad moments. The 18th.
Yeah,
Kel
that.
Had a
give
great
me,
gig.
Give me four Kels rather than a Scott. Put it that way.
Okay, four Kels. The show would implode.
No, that's
the,
too
the
much.
The show just, would. That's too much.
You remember
the
year.
Almost one was too many. So we're not going to do four Kels.
Whether it was glorious or inglorious, Kelly, you're an absolute delight. I hope to see you again.
Woohoo! Very good. Very good to the control room. Charles also.
Charles. Oh, we lost Charles, did we? Oh, Charles.
Oh, Charles. He's there, yeah.
Sorry, I forgot about you. Bye.
And then let's talk about Glory, because I think we're going to disagree.
Yeah,
honestly, a tough week because
I
didn't think anyone was amazing. Oh, no, we don't. Because I'm going to go in a place
Eileen.
You don't like. Oh, Eileen for, yeah.
I'm
for
the time. Eileen.
Eileen. Who are you?
No, Eileen for sure. She, for her, like, again, mistakes still, it wasn't a perfect week. I really would have liked her, especially like anyone of the Ferris group, to use Kelly or use it as an opportunity to take out like a Kirby. I thought the desperation wasn't great. There's enough there. She fought Eileen, but the other person will make you mad. But let's give the
Eileen's indisputable.
Yeah, let's give that to
let's give it
Eileen.
To Eileen.
Okay, so on
Queen Eileen.
No, Eileen really was a challenge beast.
No, yeah, she was.
And it's Chrissy's challenge.
Well done, Eileen.
Okay. She dominated.
So on Rebels Beach. I'm going to make you so mad because you get
well, by. It's my segment.
No, well, okay, can I tell you my opinion?
Tell me your opinion.
Rihanna.
Okay, thank you for trying to troll me. Unfortunately,
no,
it's a serious segment.
I promise segment. You, can you listen to why?
Wait, really?
Rihanna had a really good week.
There's one person in control of the tribe.
Caroline.
It's Caroline.
No, I know, but I think that Caroline should have got the mark move done, even though they didn't go to a vote. I think that would have been better for her. I'm not saying that it was a bad week. She didn't have a vote.
Participation award.
No,
that's
I'm
a
dying
I haven't
to
explained
hear this.
To you why
I'm
I think Rihanna was good. She made herself valuable to the power people when she was put in a bad swap.
By listening to Caroline at the vote.
Doesn't matter. She still
okay,
did it.
But no, but also, she's so indispensable to Caroline that Caroline even tells her tribal council that the plan has changed for Mark. She puts herself probably ahead of Mark. Definitely ahead of Alex. She goes and looks for the idol, which is good. She
was
finds
a rock away
idol.
From going to the other side.
The other side would have been great for her. Like, she was fine to go to the other side and go to her allies,
she
to Kirby.
She had no control over the
she
situation.
She is essential to what's going to happen at the merge. I know that might seem weird, but she has an idol. She has two alliances, Kirby and the Middle Age Mafia. She could connect
she's
them.
She's got an idol?
She could decide. She's the one who found the idol. Oh. She could decide the power, and she has protected well enough after almost voting herself out of the game. This week, though, she has protected to be valuable. Had they gone to a vote, she still would have survived. She's made it back to Kirby on the other side at the merge, and that gives Kirby a lot of power, and I have to credit her for that.
Zero control in
Shan.
All of that.
I'm going with
no, she didn't have
that's
zero control.
That's a big resume
You're so wrong
for
that
a
she
week.
Had zero control.
What Mafia you, boss Caroline but, tells her what to do.
Yes,
I'm sorry,
and, but
you
she
don't
has appealed
like...
to Caroline. She's appealed to Caroline that she's valuable to Caroline, and when Caroline's in power, that's
Mafia
what she
lady
can do.
She follows the dummy plan.
No. What dummy plan?
Everything from last week, from this
last week.
It's just
bad.
That she sits
I'm
down at tribal council.
No.
Mafia boss Caroline goes, this is what we're doing. Okay.
Okay, good. She's gotten herself through. Honestly, they should be worried about
she
Kirby.
She doesn't know what day of the week it is.
I don't agree with you. She goes and she finds the idol. And I think, again, that you might be biased by how you feel about her in terms of how
no
she is as a TV character.
Her.
And
so
that's exactly what I'm talking about. But that's exactly what I'm talking about. But I honestly think that...
All right,
okay,
Shannon.
You can give it to Caroline too because she is controlling. I'm not saying that's untrue.
Congratulations, sweet Caroline.
There's
you're the
crowns.
Player of the week.
No, it's three.
Well done.
He doesn't listen to us. George, in Survivor and in Talking Tribal, when we vote, that's what happens. Unlike this week
well,
where the votes
Shannon
are all
Guss's
lost.
Glory or death,
yeah.
Then
you're
you can
at
hand out
he's
the participation
pointing,
award. But unfortunately, I've got to give it to the player of the week, and
okay,
that's Caroline.
Well, I think I convinced Chrissy around how... Yeah. I think, you know what, it's unfair to say... That,
there's two crowns.
That someone has
Wait,
no
there's
agency.
Two crowns.
Thank you. Yeah,
there's
where's
two
the
crowns.
Other crown?
Is there?
Take that one. Just God,
that
wrap
someone,
this.
That
well,
someone,
I'll hand out the participation
to
award.
Say that someone has no agency. All of that
Everyone,
is interaction.
No, I
when you are making
shit,
yourself valuable
that.
To someone,
you know
that
what?
Is on
you.
That is on you. Sometimes that's all you can do is show
in,
your worth and your value.
No, it's not that. Everyone's valuable in Survivor because everybody can influence the gameplay. What I don't like in terms of Survivor gameplay are people that do nothing.
Well, she's not doing nothing.
She's doing absolutely nothing.
She found an idol. I don't know you care about that.
She hasn't done a lot since her ride or die left.
She hasn't. She's done this.
But this
she's
is
alive.
A lot. She's Georgie, alive. Please.
All right. She got the participation award and we'll have to move on.
Okay. Well, we only have time for one more thing and that's our chat with Kelly right after the break. Whoop, whoop. Welcome back. This week, George had a telehealth session with Kelly. Here's how it went.
Hey, Kelly, it is my absolute honor to have the chance to interview you today. From my perspective, I had an absolute ball watching you. You were such a fun Survivor player. You were such a fun Survivor character. How would you describe your time on Australian Survivor Titans v Rebels?
Oh, How can you describe such an amazing show? I mean, it was absolutely brilliant. I loved every second of it, and it's the greatest game in the world, and I can't speak highly enough of about it.
Kelly, I just had so much fun watching your game. From my perspective, it seemed like you were living your best life out there, and that joy of life that you had really came across to the audience watching at home. What made you bring that positive attitude to the game?
George, I've been a psychologist more than half my life, and I teach positive psychology every day, and I suppose I have to practice what I preach. And I just live life to its full in general, normally anyway. And why wouldn't you have that positive energy? You're on a beautiful island with incredible people playing the best game in the world. Why wouldn't you be positive? I mean, happiness just shines on that island, and I just shone with it.
Good on you, Kel. Okay. I want to know a little bit about Alex. Was it as hostile between the two of you as it seemed to us watching at home?
Look, Alex is a gorgeous young man, and I have a really big soft spot for him. And, you know, he's obviously very, got his arrogance and his haughtiness about him, but that doesn't bother me. But there was a bit of a tension, and I probably called Alex into line, whereas a lot of people on the tribe couldn't do that. But I absolutely adore Alex, and we have great banter, and I really enjoyed playing with him on the island, and I still enjoy doing that now. So, yeah, it's a great frenemy energy, if you want to call it that.
If we think back to that epic tribal council when you saved Alex, what Yes. was the key decision in your mind to take control of the game to actually save him?
Look, because I went on the game pretending to be dumb and pretending to be silly and not intelligent at all, that was my cover, people didn't listen to me at all. So all day I'd been trying to talk to people about let's try and take out Tobias. And I really wanted Sarah to play her game, and I wanted to see her blossom and come out in the beautiful person that she is. And Alex was a dark horse. You know, he was one of those quiet ones they talk about. Alex wasn't a quiet one. He was out there. You could read Alex like you could just read a newspaper, but not Tobias. Just quiet, pottering around, being a bit of a wallflower, so to speak, just doing a lot of little jobs. So I was very suspicious of him going to the future. So by taking out Tobias, I annihilated the cuddle crew completely.
You actually did. Good on you. I was very impressed. I like it when people take charge of the game. I hope you feel proud of yourself.
Well, I did get into a lot of trouble, and I really worked very hard to stay on the tribe after that, because people, you know, didn't trust me. But because I was posing as very unintelligent and stupid, I basically let them believe that I was forgetful and impulsive and my brain does silly things. And that's kind of what they took from me, and it successfully worked, and people liked me and I liked them. So I suppose they let me go.
Let me take you back to the last episode, Kel. So we saw Yep. that you went home trying to stop Raymond from going home. I would say, having played in a season of heroes and villains, you went out a hero. Do you have any regrets, though, given that it cost you your game?
Look, I love Raymond. I just really wanted Raymond to get as far as he could in the game, and I'm really excited to see what he does, because he truly is a beautiful man, and he was so kind to me. When I was really cold in the early part of the game, I was so freezing because all I had was a singlet and a bikini, and Raymond was so kind, and he gave me his shirt, which is why you see me as his gamer girlfriend shirt the whole time. And he gave me his shirt, and that's a really big thing in a game like Survivor, and people don't realize that was very special, and it meant a lot to me. So for me, I never forget those beautiful things that people do for me, and I wanted to pass that on.
Would you play the game again, Kel?
Oh, absolutely. Not 1 minute of my life would I not play that game. When I got off the island, George, I wanted to run straight back on the island, and I wanted to do it all again. I just loved every moment on it. It was just it's so brilliant. How can you not want to play this game again? Loved it.
You had so many big moments out there. What was your favorite moment in the game?
Look, I really love the challenges. It's really hard because I'm a little pocket rocket, and I try and give everything a go. So I think on that first challenge where I had that big, massive ball that weighed 130 kilos when I weigh like 52 kilos, I think smashing that down, lining that up for me was such an invigorating moment because it was our first big challenge together besides the fire. So for me, that was I came in as a bang into the tribe, and I've left as a bang. So that's what I wanted to do on this game. So, yeah, that was my greatest moment, I think.
Well, Rebel Kel, thank you so much for your time. You leave a hero. You brought so much fun, joy, and entertainment. I'm going to miss you. I hope you feel proud of yourself.
Thank you so much. And whoop, whoop. See you, everyone. Rebel Kel loves you all. Thanks, George. Bye.
Thanks, Kelly.
That's all we have time for. We'll be back next Tuesday after episode 15 of Titans v Rebels. If you'd like more from us or Survivor in general, the podcast has exclusive chat from tonight's episode, and there's plenty of extra Survivor content on Template. As a parting gift, enjoy a sneak peek of the next episode of Titans v Rebels, which airs 7:30 Sunday on 10 and Template. See you next week.
Kitty and Caroline, what I've seen yesterday from those two ladies was very impressive.
So Veeam, she just started playing really offensively. It felt like she was out for us.
Yeah. They explained the reasons why they got rid of Viola. But for me, you cross my girl, you're gonna go next.
I feel like this game now gets a little bit dirty.
I made a massive step going into this merge now. Me and Mark, we'll definitely be a pair couple. We'll destroy everyone who decided to put the vote against Viola. The war is about to start.